Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. One person is dead after an early morning house fire in Tuftonboro. Investigators say the fire was reported just after 1 a.m. on Barber Pole Road. Two people were inside. One got out safely. The other did not. Now the state fire marshal's office has been called in to investigate. Ray Brewer picks up the story.
It was mid-morning when firefighters made the grim discovery. A woman's body found inside of what remains of the house at 34 Barber Pole Road in Tuftonboro.
We did recover a victim, and I can't discuss who that is, and only the medical examiner and autopsy is going to be done this afternoon.
Fire officials say the fatal fire was reported just after 1 in the morning by the homeowners, who, according to neighbors, are an elderly couple who have lived there for a while. When firefighters arrived, the husband, whose name has not been released, was outside. His wife, however, was trapped. The Tuftonboro chief says when they arrived 13 minutes after getting the call, it was impossible to get inside the home to search.
The whole house was heavily involved at the time, and the house is unsafe and questionable as far as life safety.
Compounding the difficulty for firefighters, an underground propane tank was feeding the fire. And then there was the problem of getting water to the scene, even though the house is on the lake. The home is in a seasonal neighborhood. The road's very narrow. The fire would go to three alarms in part to make sure there was adequate tankers to shuttle water.
Basically, all you can do is offload the water and get the trucks back out. The fire boat from Moultonboro, which they just put in service this year, was a very big help.
Finally, after 2 hours, the fire was declared under control. As far as what started the fire, the husband told firefighters it started on the outside of the house, but the cause remains under investigation.
Now, one firefighter was injured in this. He was taken to the hospital for smoke inhalation and general exhaustion. An overnight fire damaged a home in Peterborough. Investigators say the two-alarm fire started just before 1 at the home on Greenfield Road. Crews from 7 towns were called in to respond. 3 people were home. They managed to escape without any injuries. Investigators are still looking into the cause. And another home in Franklin caught fire twice yesterday. Investigators say a fire first started in the basement at the home on Salisbury Road, but crews quickly put it out. But 4 hours later, the house caught fire again, bringing 55 firefighters to the scene. No one was home or hurt. The state fire marshal's office is also investigating that. Well, at least 2 Granite State ski resorts are now open. Both Bretton Woods and Loon Mountain say they've had good conditions for making snow and open today. Meanwhile, Waterville Valley says they'll likely open tomorrow. Cannon Mountain, Cranmore Mountain, Mount Sunapee, and Ragged Mountain are scheduled to open next week. And we will be tracking that breaking news coming out of the Gulf of Mexico this afternoon, where an oil rig has exploded. It's located about 25 miles off the coast of Grand Isle, Louisiana. 4 people have been taken to the hospital. 2 others are missing. We'll have the latest on that at 5. And stay tuned here to our website, WMUR.com, for the latest updates. That does it for us. Have a great weekend, everybody.